Hello, my name is Dennis Burson. I am the Extension Meat Specialist for the Animal Science Department at the University of Nebraska. We conduct a swine carcass contest for the 4-H market hogs at the Nebraska State Fair. This presentation will address the carcass evaluation measurements and will also review the determination of value for the market hogs that are sold to Hormel Foods. Swine exhibitors at the Nebraska State Fair have the option of entering their market hogs in the carcass evaluation contest. In addition, all hogs are marketed to Hormel Foods after the event, and all swine exhibitors will be paid for their market hog from Hormel Foods. In this presentation, I want to review the measurements taken for the swine carcass competition and the measurements taken by Hormel for the lean payment system and how the price for payment is determined. The carcass evaluation is evaluated by grouping market hogs in ribbon groups by carcass weight and the 10th rib back fat, and then ranking the groups by fat-free lean percentage. For any pork carcass, the composition of the carcass consists of lean meat, fat, skin, and bone. The fat-free lean percentage is the weight of the pork carcass that is in lean meat as compared to the weight of the carcass. A strong estimate of fat-free lean percentage is determined by a prediction equation. This equation uses the following factors: back fat thickness at the 10th rib, loin muscle area at the 10th rib, the sex of the pig, whether it's a barrel or a gilt, and the carcass weight. Increasing back fat decreases the fat-free lean percentage. Increasing the loin muscle area increases the fat-free lean percentage. Gilts normally have increased fat-free lean percentage. And as carcass's weight increases for an individual pig, the fat-free lean percentage decreases. Therefore, all these measurements are important to predict the lean. The back fat and the loin muscle area are most easily measured using ultrasound technology. The picture on the left is an ultrasound scan of fat, muscle, and bones at the 10th rib of the pig. In this image, the midline or spine of the pig is on the left side of the image, and on the right side is the outer side of the pig. The second image on the right side of the screen includes the drawings for the locations of fat, muscle, and bones. The ultrasound image on the left demonstrates the measurement of the back fat at the midpoint of the loini muscle. Note the red line runs from the outside skin surface to the edge of the loin eye muscle. You may also see other lines in the back fat. For market hogs, two or three layers of fat may be seen in an ultrasound image. The ultrasound image on the right indicates the measurement of the loin muscle area. Both the back fat thickness and the loin muscle area are measured by the ultrasound technician using the image tools on the ultrasound instrument. These two measurements, plus the sex of the pig and the carcass weight, are used for the calculation of fat-free lean percentage and the determination of carcass merit for the carcass contest. Now let's look at the Hormel buying program using the lean pork value table. The lean pork value table is applied to the carcass using carcass measurements of back fat and weight measured during the slaughter process. To start the calculation of price, Hormel Foods will establish a base price for the carcass. The base price depends on current market prices at the time of the sale. For this example, I will use a base price of $60 per cut weight. Per cut weight means that for every 100 pounds of carcass weight, $60 of the base price will be paid. You can also convert the price to a 1-pound basis by dividing the price by 100. In this example, the base price would be 60 cents per pound. Secondly, the lean pork value table is used to determine any premium or discount to be added to the base price. Carcass weight, listed on the left-hand side, and grade or last rib back fat, listed at the top of each column in the table, are used. These two factors determine the amount to be added to or subtracted from the base price. In the table, you can see a green line that indicates the optimum carcass weights for Hormel Foods. Carcass weights between 174 and 229 pounds are optimum. Using a 75% yield, this translates to a live weight of approximately 232 pounds versus 305 pounds. In addition, optimum carcass premiums based on weight and back fat are in the red box area. Carcasses weighing between 181 and 215 pounds with a last rib back fat between 0.51 and 1.1 receive the highest premiums from the table. In addition, no premium is paid for carcasses with back fat of 0.5 inches or less. Also, a carcass below 174 pounds or above 230 pounds is discounted in price. And carcasses with a last rib back fat over 1.31 inches are also discounted. You will want to note the last rib back fat used in the lean pork value table is a different measurement than the ultrasound measurement used for the carcass contest. The picture indicates the approximate location on the carcass for the last rib back fat. The fat measurement includes measurement of the skin and the fat at the midline split of the carcass. I will use these three market hogs to demonstrate the use of the pork lean value grid. The white pig, number 495, has an ultrasound measurement of back fat at the 10th rib of 0.47 inches. The carcass from 495 has a last rib back fat measurement of 0.8 inches and a carcass weight of 198 pounds. The measurements on the carcass for the lean pork value table for the carcass of the white pig 495 provides a premium of $4 to be added to the base price. The premium is determined by following the carcass weight row of 198 to the intersection of the last rib back fat column of 0.8 inches. The premium is circled on the table in red. Since our base price was set at $60, then the price per cut weight of this carcass would be $64. The carcass weight and the last rib back fat are in the optimum area of the lean pork value table, resulting in the highest premium added to the base price. The red pig, 491, has an ultrasound measurement of back fat at the 10th rib of 0.98 inches. The measurement of the carcass of the last rib back fat was 1.4 inches, and the carcass weight was 216 pounds. The use of the lean pork value table and the carcass measurements of the last rib back fat and the carcass weight from the carcass of the red 491 pig produces a discount of $11.25 per cut weight. The discount is determined by following the carcass weight row to the intersection of the last rib back fat column, which is circled in red on the table. Since our base price was set at $60, then the price per cut weight for this carcass would be $48.75 per cut weight. The last rib back fat exceeded the premium range of the lean pork value table and resulted in a major discount from the base price. The third pig is the black belted pig number 500. It has an ultrasound measurement for back fat at the 10th rib of 0.75 inches. The carcass measurements, however, for last rib back fat were 1 inch and the carcass weight was 247 pounds. These carcass measurements of last rib back fat and carcass weight for the carcass of the black belted pig resulted in a discount of $18. The discount is determined again by following the carcass weight for the row with 247 pounds to the intersection of the last rib back fat column for 1 inch in the lean value table. The price discount is circled in red in the table. With the base price at $60, then applying the discount results in a price per cut weight of $42. The carcass weight for this carcass was well beyond the optimum area of the lean pork value table and resulted in the highest discount added to the base price. After premiums and discounts are determined, the total value for each pig can be calculated by multiplying the dollars per cut weight times the carcass weight and dividing by 100. The calculation results in significant total value differences for each of the market's hogs used as our examples. The white market hog, 498, was the only market hog that fit within the optimum weight and back fat on the lean pork value table. Pig 498 had the highest total value of $133.12. It is interesting to note that 498 was the lightest market weight hog used in this group. The red market hog, 491, had excessive last rib back fat of 1.4 inches, and the discount resulted in a lower total value of $105.30, or approximately $28 less than that of the white hog, 498. In addition, the black belted market hog, 500, was excessively heavy with a carcass weight of 247 pounds. This resulted in a large discount for a total value of $103.74. The black belted pig was 39 pounds heavier than the white pig, 498. However, because of the discount, the black belted 500 pig was $29 lower in total value. The three market hogs used in this presentation had a total carcass weight of 671 pounds and a total or gross value of $342.16. However, the payment to the owner of the market hogs will include costs incurred during the sale of the market hogs. For payment purposes, three costs are normally deducted from the total value. This includes the pork checkoff cost, the trucking cost, and the insurance cost. Pork checkoff costs are calculated by multiplying the total or gross value times 0.004. The trucking costs, they will be assigned per hog and will be calculated based on the total trucking cost and the number of hogs delivered. Insurance costs are also included to cover the market hogs delivered to the plant. So the payment to the owner will include deductions for checkoff, trucking, and insurance. So to summarize the information in this presentation, in carcass contests, market hogs are ranked in ribbon groups based on the calculation of fat-free lean percentage. An estimate of fat-free lean is determined by the ultrasound measurement of back fat over the center of the loin muscle, the measurement of loin muscle area, the carcass sex of barrel or gilt, and the carcass weight. The price of a market hog on the lean pork value system is determined from use of a base price and premiums or discounts determined by carcass weight and last rib back fat. To achieve the best payment for market hogs, the carcasses need to be in the optimum range for weight and back fat. A good target for maximum value is to have carcass weights between 174 and 229 pounds and carcass back fat between 0.51 and 1.31 inches.